What's up, guys? I'm at Fort Pickens, Pensacola Beach. About to go do some kayak fishing. Take a quick second to kind of go over the rig as it is right now. This is my first shot out. Just got here late last night. Haven't been out yet. I don't have any bait. Gonna try and use sabiki to drum the bait up. But what we're looking at here is a Jackson Big Tuna. We got it configured for one person. We've got an Igloo Marine cooler that fits very nicely in the back there. I'll secure everything with bungee cords, as you can see. I got the Orion, but the Orion won't fit. It's just too big. So, got the Igloo Marine cooler. Basically what I'm using this for, there's no ice in it. I'm just using it as like gear storage on this trip. Sometimes I'll put ice in it, drinks, or you know, use for fish, that sort of thing. And that's pretty much it. I got my rack going. Before I came out, I went in and I resealed all the glued spots on the rack, all the load-bearing spots like this. Just resealed that with glue, just to make sure it's a good hold. Now it does move a little bit, but that's okay. Like I don't ever lock down the reels when I've got lines in the water. The clicker is always on. Sorry, I got the hiccups for some reason this morning. So yeah, if you're going to use like a PVC rack like this, make sure when you put a bait in the water that, you know, the clicker's on and it's not, you know, big fish is going to rip that right off. It is secure. It does flex a little bit, and I think most of the flex is actually coming from down here. So the rack itself isn't flexing, it's the flush mount rod holders inside the boat, which reminds me I probably need to reseal those because it's been a season without any sealing on those. There it is, real simple loadout. I don't think I'm going to set up the Lowrance on this trip, even though I have it with me. I could set it up while out on the water, but I don't know. I just want to troll around and just get in the water, so I'm not going to use that. How I mount my Lowrance is, I've got a nice gear track here that I've mounted to the top of the tuna tank. So I will just run that mount right there underneath the seat, and then battery in the back. That's how I roll with that. Let's see. Another camera mount right here. Gear track mounted to the rack. Camera right there. This camera that I'm using actually. So there it is, guys. Not complicated, real simple. Got a sabiki rod, a casting rod, and two trolling rods. Alright, so thanks for checking out the video. Y'all let me know if you have any questions. Let's go catch some fish.